So good morning, everyone. This is Donia here, Marketing Manager at Aircross Aviations Private Limited, and I will be giving you a short presentation on the top places to promote your event blogs. And here we will be taking an example of our recent event, which is an online aviation training program, which is a 1 week certificate program in airport management as well as customer service. Now, talking about the different ways, the first one would be a very familiar way for all of us, which is a Facebook page. A Facebook page can be created for your blog, and the good thing about this is that you can find a lot of audience and it will generate a lot of traffic to the fan page. But the problem would be to identify what are your target segments, because this is a mass marketing tool. And this is one example where we published the event on Facebook page. Then coming to Facebook groups. So there are groups for almost every topic on Facebook. And the good thing about this is that if you directly post on a Facebook fan page, it is not going to a targeted audience. But if you post something on a Facebook group, it goes to a targeted audience. And thus, you will be able to get more conversion, a better conversion rate than a Facebook post. And here you need to take into account all the group rules, because a lot of groups would not like any blog promotion, and that can create a negative impact on your event. But still, joining discussions and connecting with people who are in your niche is a good way of promotion as well. Then coming to Facebook stories. So Facebook stories is, as most of us might be knowing, it stays for 24 hours. So here you can share a link to your content, unlike Instagram, which requires a verified and a minimum number of followers. Here you can share link to your blog website, and people can drive traffic from your Facebook to your blog. And this is an example of that. Then coming to another method, which is Twitter. So Twitter is also kind of like Facebook, but it is more effective in the manner that you can start discussions in Twitter. So here, people love content, people love discussing about different things in Twitter. So here you can actually drive a lot of traffic from Twitter to your account. The problem here, or the thing that has to be considered here, is that you need to invest significant amount of time in Twitter, because you have to build a significant audience as well. And this is example of how we promoted our event on Twitter. Another thing is Twitter conversations. So once you tweet your content, there is something called Twitter conversations, where people discuss about your topic. People can raise questions about it, and you can provide answers to it. And a lot of trails might come up, and people can read up on it as well. So here, one good thing about this is that a lot of keywords will be generated here, and any search or something can actually point towards your event post. Then something else is called the Twitter Moments. So Twitter Moments allow you to group together all the related tweets and give them some extra visibility. So if for an event you have about 3-4 tweets that you have done, you can club them together and create a Twitter Moment. This can also be helpful in reinstating your promotions technique, and then again driving traffic to your blog post. Then coming to LinkedIn. LinkedIn is actually a very important tool, especially if you are having an event which is in a professional capacity. So two methods is through LinkedIn feed and through LinkedIn groups. In LinkedIn feed, only your connections will be able to see your post, and you can market on this, especially if you have a LinkedIn network which is related to the event that you're posting, and if the event is significant to them. So here there is a method of driving traffic, whereas in LinkedIn groups, you can find groups just like in Facebook. You can find groups for a lot of topics in LinkedIn, so you just need to find those groups which are relevant to your blog, and you need to engage in that group, and you need to be active in that group. Then only you will also see result in the same. Those examples of our LinkedIn promotions. Now coming to LinkedIn publishing. So LinkedIn publishing actually allows you to publish your content, and this is to a highly targeted niche audience. This can also be done in Facebook as well, wherein you have to drop in your niche audience. For this, you need to have very good idea about who your target audience are, and you need to direct your publishing to that particular niche. And the problem here is that it might not drive a lot of traffic, but the conversion that you get from here will be high because these are highly targeted. Then comes Pinterest. So Pinterest is also gaining a lot of popularity in attracting people and holding their interest especially. So what you can do here is Pinterest, you can actually post on Pinterest and people can watch it and pin it, and people who follow a person's boards will also be able to see what they have pinned. And in this manner, you can drive traffic. But for this also, you need to be very active on Pinterest. You need to invest your time. You need to understand how this works and again, be consistent with your Pinterest activity. Then comes Pinterest group boards. So here, what you have to do is you can join group boards that already have good amount of followers, and it would be better if the followers are related to your niche, and then you can post to these boards, and so that you can not only reach your personal followers, your personal account followers, but also the board followers. Then comes Tailwind communities. So there is something called Tailwind communities where the groups are called Tailwind tribes. So what happens here is you can enter these tribes, and then you have to share a few of those pins that are there that have been already been posted, and then you post your pins. After that, you can expect people who are further joining in to repost or add those pins. Share those pins. Then coming to Medium. So Medium is actually a website which is used for promotion. What you can do here is you can upload your story in Medium, wherein you can write a post and then maybe curate the content a little, and then make sure that your title and the first paragraph of the article is catchy. Then only you will be able to attract followers, because people will not be reading the entire story. And when you share as well, you will the synopsis only will be shown in the beginning. And one thing you can do to get Medium followers is to connect your Medium account to your Twitter account, because there is a provision that is being provided. So in this case, what happens is the people who follow you on Twitter will automatically be your followers on Medium as well. So it the time that is taken to build a customer base or follower base is eliminated in this method. So this is an example of how we promoted it on Twitter. Medium. Then comes Medium publication. So this is also an extension of what we have done right now. What you can do is you can publish your stories just like how you how magazines are being published. So you can create your publication, and then you can invite other contributors also for it. So the thing here is that to find publications from your niche that you can submit or apply to, that is a little tricky, because you need to do a lot of research and find out those particular niche categories, and then only you'll be able to promote. Otherwise, it will not deliver that much results as you expect. Then coming to Quora. Quora is also a very sought after platform, because it is, as everyone, most of you might be knowing, it is a question answer platform. So here, to promote your content, what you need to do is you need to be able to find that particular question which is exactly in line with your blog event, and you need to provide an answer to that question with a small short synopsis on the event, and then provide the link to that particular blog post. So here what happens is, for this to be to add traffic to your blog website, this answer has to be upvoted. Then only it will provide results. And this is an example of how we promoted on Quora. So here you can see we gave a short synopsis about the program and provided an answer to this question. The question is it good to join aviation courses? So here we mentioned why this aviation course is good for you. And then we provide a link below, where we mentioned we try to drive traffic from Quora to our website. Then there's something called Quora Spaces. So here you use Quora Spaces to create collections of information around a specific topic. And within these spaces, we can promote our blog. But here we need to simply syndicate a shorter version of your post and link, just as we did in the comments in the answer part. And you can also publish a roundup on Quora that mentions several of your articles on one topic. So if you have a lot of articles on your blog, then you can publish all of those articles as a roundup. Then comes forums. So forums and discussion groups, they are also a good way to promote your content. So here also, it is coming from a niche. So our aviation program was a very niche program. And that is why forums also is a good method to do it. But the problem here is that you need to be aware of the rules and rules of the forum. So if a forum is about a particular topic, you need to be actively participating in the discussions related to that topic. And you need to be active in the group and forum. So that then only people will be interested in reading about your content. Otherwise, you will be termed as a spammer to that group. Then coming to blog comments. So if you find a blog which is related to your event, then you can actually promote through blog comments, wherein you can mention some information about your program and then give your link as well. But in some cases, some blogs do not allow that link to be provided in the comment section. But this is also a good way to drive traffic to your blog site. This is an example of the same. Then coming to guest posts. So guest posts is something where you as a blogger will post something in another blogger's website. So that is called a guest post. And a lot of people actually do allow that. A lot of bloggers actually allow that. So what happens, or the benefit here, is that if you find a person who provides guest posts and they are related to the niche that you want to target, then you can post in that particular website, and you will be able to drive traffic not from your own followers, but from the followers of that particular blogger as well. Then coming to newsletters, this is related to email marketing, wherein if you have a new post that is being published, you can send an email to all of your subscribers. So here we have an example of how we did that. This is our email marketing campaign, wherein we sent a newsletter to all the subscribers of that database with a link to join a WhatsApp group and a link to the website as well. Then coming to a new blog post. So if you have an event, you can actually also come up with a new blog post. It can be a summary as well, wherein you can be creative here. You can pick up all the two or three blog posts that you've already had related to this particular topic, and then come up with a summary and then post a new one. So here it should not be reiterating the exact same thing. It should be a little bit cooler end as well. So this is an example of a new post that we had. Then coming to SlideShare. So SlideShare is every time you search for some topic, you will probably find a SlideShare link in the first or second page of your Google search. So SlideShare has a good penetration or a reach. So what you can do is if you can create a small slide or a PPT and then upload it in SlideShare. So this can also attract audience via Google search and also via the SlideShare search as well. Then coming to Instagram, here you cannot share links on Instagram, but you can share it in your bio. But the thing with Instagram is that you can have a branding effect, and that also plays an important role in your promotion. Then coming to Instagram stories. Instagram stories is also a method that you can use, but the problem here is you need to have a verified account or a business account with over 10K followers. Then coming to Snapchat, Snapchat also works like Instagram stories only, but the difference is that you can add links here. So you can directly drive traffic to your blog site. Then coming to Reddit. So Reddit is claiming to be the front page of the internet. So here, Reddit is a social news aggregation site. So a lot of people vote on content, they share content, they discuss in their comment section and so on. There are discussions on many topics. So if a piece of content has a lot of upvotes, then it has immense power to drive huge traffic. So here the thing is you also need to be active in Reddit. Otherwise your account itself might be locked or banned. Then coming to YouTube. YouTube is also a very powerful tool, but here the problem is you can only share videos. So here you can create a video related to your event and then share it. And this also can drive traffic. And in the description part, you can give the link to your website post. So this is a video that we had shared. Then coming to Vimeo. Vimeo is a tool wherein you is a tool for creating videos for YouTube, but here this also has a good customer base. The thing here is that the customer base is slightly older of age. So it did not make a lot of sense for us to market in this site because we were targeting at younger the youth population. Then comes the link roundups. So just like we mentioned earlier, you can have a roundup of different links that you have of the blogs you've published, and then create a roundup wherein you can say the best of those best of the links that are there on the web. Here also, a lot of other bloggers also do this. So the thing here is that you cannot just wait for people to stumble upon your topic and then come up with it. But here, what you can do is you can reach out to the bloggers who do this and then suggest your link. And here you cannot suggest all content that you have. You need to be able to suggest the best content. Then adding it to your email signature. This is pretty basic. You just need to add a link to your email signature, and everyone who receives your email might have a look at that link and then again drive traffic. Then coming with mention sources and interview partners. Here what you can do is you can reach out to many bloggers or marketers or influencers and get them to advocate your event. Then coming to Scoopit. Scoopit is also a content curation platform. What you can do is you can create your own page and add your content to your topic pages. So here you need to develop an audience base also to the content. Then comes Flipboard. Flipboard is kind of like a magazine. It's a board where you can curate your content into magazines. So if you have a magazine, people will follow that magazine, and that magazine should be related to a particular topic. And here you can add in your details, and the followers to that particular magazine will be able to see the promotion and your event and get the details. Then comes Trendy. So Trendy is a very premium one. So here you cannot directly post anything. You have to submit something, and only if your content is good enough and it is trendy enough or hot enough, then only they will review it and then agree to post your content. Then coming to your older post, if you have a post which has got a lot of viewers and traffic in the recent past, what you can do is you can link that post to your current to this event website. I mean the event webpage or your event post, and this way you can drive your traffic from this old post to your new post. So this is kind of like internal linking to your website. So this is how we did. If you can see, there was a website here, and we added a comment here with the link, as well as we provide a small icon on the end on the side where you can go through that website as well. Then comes Tribber. Tribber is also a platform where you can join communities and discuss about the content. Here also you can post the content here, and then people can share it like in Facebook and Instagram. Then Bloglovin is there. Bloglovin is also an app which helps you discover and follow blogs. Here also you can add your blog and people can follow you. What you need to take care of is that your first image, your introductory sentences, and your title. These have to be very catchy to get followers to reach that web page. So this is an example of what we did in Bloglovin. Then again, BlogEngage. BlogEngage is also a similar type of community where you can submit your blog post. So here what happens is users will vote on those submissions, and only if it gets enough votes, it'll be promoted on the BlogEngage homepage. So if you reach BlogEngage homepage, that is where you get traffic, significant traffic to your blog post. And the last one is Zest.is. This is also a content sharing and discovery platform. So every piece of content here has to be approved by a team of marketers. So this is also a very premium one where only it, they claim that only 1% of the entire content is being sub, is being approved. So these websites, you need to be able to curate your content so much so that you, you know that your content is stellar. So that is all about the tools that you can use. The key here is that understanding your target customers and your target population and being able to use those tools which are the best for you. Like how I said, Vimeo actually targets a older population, which does not do us any good. So what you need to do is you need to identify your target population and find out what tools among these list will best suit you. So that is it from my end. Thank you and have a nice day.